Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Yeah, I don't want to diagnose this, in your case, just from the school on the streets and studying human behavior. But women, on average, are told, hey, get your dad to stay at home, make him Mr. Mom. You go out and make the money, or you run the career. That's a great thing to do. And most of the time, women end up not respecting that and getting rid of you and getting what they see as an alpha male. That's just the way the biology works here on this planet. And the system knows all that, so they try to change that. And then women are told, use the system, do whatever you want. I mean, I think something like almost 80% of divorces are filed by women. And men are slobs, and men oppress women. I mean, it's usually an abuser relationship. You'll have a man abusing a woman, or you'll have a woman abusing a man. And they're always entitled and have excuses for what they're doing. But I've heard about these cases where the cop gets your wife. And then it's like something out of a movie where the whole system's now against you, and now the gang lines up against you and you're in deep crap. But that's bearing false witness. And generally, when the system figures that out, that person ends up getting in a lot of trouble. But I haven't even heard your story yet. I'm just guessing. Bill's calling from Minnesota, a musician, married to his wife, staying there. They have a development business. Doing very well. Boom. Suddenly, he's kicked out of the house. A cop moves in. What happened from there on out?
Okay, so I had to, you know, I was homeless. Then I took a job as a janitor and had to get an apartment for myself. Then, you know, well, right away.
But see, a man wouldn't even usually on average go after the woman like that, because a woman on average sees it psychologically. The studies are there that they own you. You know, you're supposed to take care of them, even though it's vice versa. They want this equal system. And so you're taking care of the kids. Now you're thrown out. You would have immediately gone to a lawyer, forced the sale of the house, all the rest of it, the assets. But see, the system just let her lock you out, and now you're homeless. Go ahead.
So when I caught her that night with the cop, I go in the house and turn on my... I called the police right away because I didn't even know he was a cop. I just knew there was a guy in the house. So I called the police. I start recording on my iPhone. And the first thing I asked, I went upstairs, went to the guy, and I said, do you know my child? Have you been around my daughter? And I filmed the whole thing, and everybody that's seen it's like, wow, you know, you just caught your wife with another man. I can't believe how calm you were and everything. Well, the police told me that to leave. And I'm like, no, it's my house. We own it together. Look at my license, you know. I'm on the deed. And they said, well, here's the deal. If she says she's scared of you, you go to jail. And she hasn't done that, so you better just count your blessings and get out of here. And then I was like,
No. And again, they were implying, we'll let her fraudulently say this if you don't leave our brother alone. And those cops are going to wonder why their kids are in car accidents, why they get cancer. I mean, I'm telling you, it's a law of the universe. You use power to oppress somebody, you can kiss your butt goodbye in the future, and God will serve it cold. And that's a terrible, terrible thing that happened to you. So where did it go from there?
So I ended up leaving. She filed an order for protection on me.
They told her to do that. And then you didn't have the money probably to go get a lawyer to impeach that and prove it was a fraud.
I did. Because
you did.
I had the video. And I had an attorney that...
Hold on, here's the deal. I got Bob Barr coming up for 30 minutes. This is an important story because people are already into it. So we're going to recap it and cover it at the bottom of the hour. Can you hold?
Yeah.
Yeah, people need to hear this because this is the way this works. And they've set it up. This is modern feminism where the state's the man with the woman on her side, but only to break up your family because they want to get her in the end. But in this case, the state's also sleeping with her. Bill, stay there. Then we'll go to Frank, Phil, Steve, and others. James, after Bob Barr leaves us, stay with us. I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. Most people know that iodine deficiency has been a crisis around the world. Iodine is key to so many of the body's functions, especially the thyroid. I discovered a product being developed by Dr. Group. You now know it as Survival Shield, true nascent iodine that your body can really absorb. Then, about a year ago, he said, listen, if you think this is powerful, I'm going to come out with rare earth, deep earth crystals. And the results that I personally have had have been life-changing. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovating, and the best part is it helps fund InfoWars.com, the radio show, the TV show, the whole media operation promoting true libertarian ideas.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off super detox special at InfoWarsLife.com. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. I've always believed in nutrition and herbs. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Sourced from powerful organic herbs harvested around the planet and then concentrated for maximum potency.
I just received my Male Vitality about 3 days ago, and I must say, that is good stuff.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality and getting the day started.
It's not just the Super Male Vitality. All the products at InfoWarsLife.com are simply amazing. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Bob Barr represented the 7th District of Georgia from 95 to 2003, and I remember him really criticizing the NSA, the spying, the police state to a great extent, and being 100% pro-Second Amendment, national sovereignty. I mean, I'd call him a paleo-conservative constitutionalist with a big libertarian streak. Facebook.com, Bob Barr Congress. We'll give you his main website as well on screen for TV viewers. But he's with us to the bottom of the hour. Then I'll get into all the other world news after I take phone calls for folks that are patiently holding. But the reason I wanted to get him on today was to talk about the waterfront. His take on what's going on with Obama giving awards to illegal alien kids to obviously encourage them to come up here. What the plan in that crisis he thinks is, or whether he thinks it's ineptitude, what's happening in Iraq with this ISIS group, and where he sees Hillary and Obama making all these cryptic anti-gun statements about executive orders. We need Australian-style bans. Obama said that last week on CBS. I mean, this is getting really scary because he's outdone Nixon times 1,000, in my view. But he's just moving forward. And my gut, my spidey sense says, danger Will Robinson. So running for Congress in the lead, doesn't mean he'll win, but we definitely need him in there, is Bob Barr. But before we get into all those subjects, I wanted to first ask the former congressman, soon to be congressman, knock on wood, what is your take on a lot of Tea Party, true conservative libertarian candidates beating blue blood Republicans in Texas, in Virginia with Bratt and others, and the media spinning it? Oh, the Tea Party's been discredited while a lot of blue bloods won. That's not what I'm seeing in the numbers. And the Republican attempts, with the Democrats to try to block to the Tea Party, I only see real reform of the Republicans towards more of what their platform is, towards their only hope. Compromising with the Democrats is what is extincting the Republican Party. Now, I'm not as politically savvy, obviously, as you, as senior in the CIA, a federal prosecutor before that, somebody who was done international negotiations, a congressman. But is that approximation I made accurate, or can you augment it or disagree with it?
I certainly wouldn't disagree with that, not only because you're the host of this show, but because you're right. The fact of the matter is that the Cantor's loss, and I know Eric Cantor, I like him, and he was doing a credible job as majority leader, but he suffered from two things. One, what we call in the legal profession, robitis. Judges, once they get elected or appointed, they don the black robe and they kind of, put themselves above the people and lose touch. The lesson number one for Eric is, no matter how important your work in Washington is, even if the people in your district support you in being a leader in the Congress, because that brings prestige and so forth to your district, you cannot, except at your own peril, forget the people back home. You can't become so enamored of Washington power that you forget the people that sent you there and the people that you ultimately answer to. Secondly, though, I think those who try and downplay the importance of what Congressman-elect, I guess he's not Congressman-elect, but for all intents and purposes, Bratt, represents, is he represents a deep-seated and continuing movement among conservatives in this country to get people into office and keep people in office who will actually move our conservative agenda, not Washington's agenda, but our conservative agenda forward. And that's what I'm hearing here in the 11th District of Georgia, and I suspect that that's exactly what Mr. Bratt was hearing in the 7th District of Virginia.
And again, the districts have been rewritten. You were in the 7th, now you're running in the 11th, which is much of Atlanta, one of the most important districts in the country, with all these new Tea Party people that are going to be getting into office for the first time. I think it's going to be great to have somebody like you, I would call paleo Tea Party or proto Tea Party. You were one of the few voices that would say things like Ron Paul was saying when you were there. I mean, I think your leadership, knock on wood, as I said, is going to be so key getting back into Congress. The sense I get now from Democrats that I've never seen in almost 20 years on air, and talking to family who've been politically involved and active for 50 years, they've never seen Democrats this freaked out and realizing they've been betrayed. I don't care what color they are. Cities from Virginia to New York, with tens of thousands of illegals showing up. The country's in a deep recession, depression in areas. I don't know what the Democrats think they're doing, being so incredibly radical and so incredibly criminal with the actions they're doing. I mean, I've never seen, and in history never seen, an American presidency act like this. I don't think there's words to describe how bad it is. So, what is your take on the seismic shift I see happening? How would you describe that shift, or do you agree it's happening? And B, what are the Democratic leaders thinking? C, what will they pull to try to get themselves out of this?
This president is so bad, he makes Jimmy Carter look like one of our best presidents ever.
Yes.
I mean, that's how bad this guy is. And I know there's a lot of speculation, Alex, that it's not just sheer incompetence it being that we're witnessing, although there is deep-seated incompetence in this administration. You just listened to Susan Rice, his UN ambassador, babble on about the Bergdahl case or something else, and you realize these are vacuums that we're listening to, their knowledge of world affairs or Middle Eastern affairs or military affairs. It isn't that it's a mile wide and an inch deep. It